Hey there, my name is Dimitri, and I know what it's like to have a bit of a messy workflow. I used to have a messier workflow, and then I got unmessy. You know how I got unmessy? By working at it, and by using different tools to make me not messy. In all seriousness, in this video, I'm gonna dive into the top tools to save you from clutter and messiness in 2024. With that being said, let's give you a little bit of the background on how I got to this point. So I was somebody who was extremely messy. I used to use so many different physical tools to keep everything organized, and this would make me feel scattered. I never had any data to reference. I never had typed out text or information that kept me accountable. I would always deal with a pen and paper. And while it sort of worked, I just felt scattered because there was no centralized place for me to go to, and a piece of paper for me just never worked that great. But now I have a couple different tools that really help me stay organized. And first of all, you're probably gonna guess which one it is. It is Notion. Notion is one of my favorite tools for keeping me organized on projects, notes, and helping me track my to-do list on one clean and customizable interface. So inside of my Rise Productive Hub, which is the name of my company, I have everything from my actions here, which is awesome to just kind of see what tasks I have for the day and go through it. I have my Rise Productive Dashboard, which showcases the different tasks that others have at the moment. And I also have a different view for what I really like, which is my meetings and notes. So Notion doesn't actually have a integration for Google Calendar just yet in the native experience. But what I do have is I have this really nice Google Calendar integration that I made myself. And what's awesome about this is I'm able to quickly go into any of my meetings by clicking on a link and then just going into a call just like this. It's awesome. But what's even more awesome is not only do I have the ability to join these quickly, but I also have an AI assistant that helps me take my notes. So as you'll see right here, we have Fathom AI note taker pop right in here. And it's a great tool. It's a great tool for a lot of reasons, because unlike other recorders, it listens to me. It joins meetings and allows me to have this meeting not only be recorded from an audio standpoint, but also from a video standpoint. I have a great experience here because I don't need to worry about anything when it comes to taking notes during meetings. I can simply just have it record and I'm there. And if I need it to stop or go, I can just press pause and then resume. And if there's anything that's going on that matters, I can highlight the specific spot in the call and add a title to it, like saying how Fathom works. Say, for example, I was giving a presentation on how this product works or something else does in a call, then I could end the highlight and it adds that to later when I need to reference that in the recordings. And it's just a very simple and useful product. Like, I can mark this moment. I can add an action item based off of what I just talked about. All of these things really do make a difference when analyzing your meetings after, and help you stay focused on the meeting so you don't have to write everything down. It's just recording it. So you're kind of in a position where you don't have to deal with the headache of writing stuff down during a meeting, while also gaining the benefit of being able to highlight something if you find it important. It helps me stay organized in so many ways. And I'd like to thank them for sponsoring this video, because Fathom really does make your meetings work for you by automatically documenting and organizing everything into a much better note-taking experience than you would have otherwise. Meetings can be messy, and your workflow is gonna get really crazy if you don't know what you're doing and you end up following what I used to do, which is just like jotting notes down on a notepad. But now this is where Fathom comes in. The automatic transcription from Fathom on your meetings organizes everything into searchable summaries. So no more sifting through messy handwritten notes like I showed here, or trying to remember what was discussed. You can simply search keywords, people's names, or topics, and Fathom will pull up the exact section of the meeting you need. It integrates with tools very easily, like Slack, making it easy to share key moments with your team or revisit important decisions in seconds. That's another way that it keeps me organized. I use Slack in my team workflows very much so. And by having it send those messages after meetings end, people can obviously go and check those different moments and have them for reference rather than having to remember them off the top of their head. It takes away my stress, and I wanted to take away your stress too. So make sure to check it out. It's so easy to go back and check your recordings. This is a recording I had previously. You'll see that there is a transcript from the call. There is a summary, and I can search up anything that I'd want in here, like really simple because I remember some of the keywords I say. I do have a decent memory, I won't lie. And you can see that it pops up right here. And if I want to make any edits to the transcript or change the speaker, all of the different things that happen automatically can be adjusted manually in here, which is great. And sending out the summary to someone via Google Doc is very convenient too. I love the bulleted summary points and love sharing links to people, showcasing the meetings we've had in order to align with them on what was discussed. And not only that, after a meeting is done, what I really like is having the ability to click on the link and go back to the call. You can set up an automation of sorts to have any recordings go back to. You can always have a automation or do manual dropping of links into a all-in-one organization tool like Notion. So then it goes back to that really nicely made calendar I had in my Notion setup. So shout out again, Fathom AI, for sponsoring this video. Really great tool. And another tool that I use to stay organized is Miro. So I have a lot of different content workflows that I go through from videos like this. There's the idea stage, then we script, then I record, then there's editings, revisions. Then when it gets reviewed by our team, it could be reviewed by a client, and then we schedule and publish it. But how does this work? Like, how does that workflow work? Well, I make different Miro boards to explain to the team with both written text and little Loom videos that walk everybody through the step-by-step process as to how these things work. If it wasn't for Loom, Notion, and Miro just like this, I wouldn't know how to get anything done consistently, and I wouldn't be able to tell people on the team how to get anything done consistently. This is the kind of stuff that I love. Now, I love organization. I love making workflows like this so that, you know, so that the work we get done is done at the same level of quality and consistency all the time. I have all these status workflows made from everything from video editing to thumbnails to scripting, and even how we like have automated systems delegate work to video editors, post writers, and thumbnail creators. It's pretty unique, and it's a process that I enjoy working on in order to inform my team members. So if you're trying to stay organized, this channel will help you out a lot. Fathom will help you out a lot. So thank you again, Fathom, for sponsoring this video. I think seriously, AI note-taking is the way of the future. So try it out today. With that being said, thank you so much for watching this video. Check out this one on how to improve your skills using productivity tools even more.